Nancy Bird Walton, you're in high air about 56 years after your last visit. What's the trip all about?
Well, the trip's for the Far West Children's Health Scheme. I decided it would be rather fun to reenact the barnstorming trip I did in 1935 and to take my book, which has just come out, called My God, It's a Woman, and sell it on behalf of the Far West Children's Health Scheme. They arrange a function, and any of the branches that want to do that, I was prepared to go to, and they make a little money out of the functions, plus the various donations that are given to them. Some of the Rotary clubs and Apex clubs and Lions clubs have made special donations and attended the functions, and even bought books for the schools. And so that's all been wonderful publicity for the Far West Children's Health Scheme, and that was the idea of it. And besides, it's rather nice for me in my twilight years to get round to all these wonderful places in the country and see what's happened since I was here, 56 years ago?
Well, I understand that you were only 17 when you first got your A licence.
That's right, yes. I had to wait until I was 19 to get a commercial licence, and then I did this barnstorming trip because there was nothing else you could do in 1935. If you wanted to stay in aviation, you had to get out and do something. The airlines, such as they were, went broke, one after the other. Kingsford Smith, the Canberra airline, the Wasp airlines, they all went broke one after the other. People just weren't ready to fly. But everybody had gone barnstorming, even Kingsford Smith himself. And I had met him on one of these trips, and then having flown with at an air pageant and then with Kingsford Smith, it became the ruling passion of my life. So the only thing to do was to get an aeroplane, go around the shows and the race meetings. In those days there were no aerodromes, so you could land in the paddock nearest the show or the race meeting, and hope that I could get some courageous people to take flights, and that gave me enough money to travel on to the next place. I don't think I made any money out of it, but at least I kept flying.
Well, I understand there's a bit of a story. You first came to Hay, those 56 years ago, it was on a Mercy Dash or something.
Oh, yes, yes. Well, when I was doing this work, you see, occasionally a charter flight would come up. The first one I took was a man who wanted to inspect a mob of sheep he had on a gistment up at Corinda. But then the second charter flight I had was the Mercy flight of picking up Dr. Lethbridge at Narandra to bring to a heart case in Hay. In fact, we'd all got ready to attend the picnic race meetings. It was going to be a great event. We were staying at Brigadier Station with Dalmeen, and then this case came up. So instead of being at the picnic race meetings, I was flying backwards and forwards from Narandra to Hay, back to Narandra, taking the doctor back, and then returning to the picnic race meeting. I think I got here in time for the ball.
Well, you've had a wonderful career, and you've been a great example for flyers generally, aviators, and particularly women. Do you feel?
Well, I don't know that I've been any inspiration to anybody, but I am the patron of the women pilots, and of course on this trip I'm seeing women pilots in their hometowns, which is wonderful. I'm going to take advantage of the inexpensive fares and go to Perth, Darwin, Adelaide, Melbourne, and I've already been to North Queensland to see them all, and that's rather wonderful because you get to know them a lot better than you do at a general meeting when you meet 150 at once. But this trip is making everybody over 75 feel good, and I know everybody's good grandfather anyhow when I get to these places. I meet the descendants of people that I knew, and a few of the old timers still left who can remember those days when we landed in paddocks and on aeroplanes that they said were made of fabric, string and wire, which isn't quite true. We thought they were pretty good aeroplanes.
Well, very much. We wish you the very best of luck with the book and with the rest of the tour.
Many thanks indeed.